What is going on, guys? Very, very special moment for me here. You're probably wondering why I'm driving on the highway recording right now. Don't worry, everything's nice and secure and safe. However, I'm on my way right now to pick up Eric Maz. And for any of you guys watching right now who don't know who Eric is, Eric's our creative director and video editor that works alongside with making my personal brand what it is today. We have a very strong partnership together and have a very close relationship on making all this content that you guys are consuming on YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, and all the other social media platforms. So how I actually met Eric, to give you guys a little bit of backstory, is I came across him on Fiverr. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of Fiverr. Fiverr is a freelance application that you can go on the web and go find people to make you websites, video editing, etc. And when I came across Eric, we actually began our relationship together in September of 2023. Now, we are just about to arrive in September here, 3 days away, currently August 28th, and it's already been a full year of me and Eric working together. So Eric's not from Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. He's from America, and must I say, he's not close to me whatsoever. He's all the way in Idaho, comes from the town called Boise. I got some special news, guys. I flew him here to Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan. I'm in Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. Sault Ste. Marie, Michigan is right across the river from us. I don't know if I've ever told you guys, but we are a border city. Full year of working together, guys. You know, he sees me making my best content and also making my worst. He gets to watch all the raw footage of me, come up with a lot of the creative ideas, and really keep me in line for making the best content possible for all of you guys to consume. He makes me look my best when he does edit my videos, of course, because I am not perfect. I just got so much appreciation from Oz. You know, we are like best friends, man, and we've never even met each other. And it's crazy to say that because these things are possible. You can meet people online and you can become very, very, very close virtually. And it's absolutely insane to think that we're gonna be able to meet in person right now after a full year of working together. Guys, when I mean a full year of working together, I mean communication every single day. Meetings, 1 hour meetings once a week. Like, I'm not talking just, you know, a couple texts here and there. Like, me and Eric are texting all day long, like true partners. We wouldn't be crushing it without Eric. And I gotta give him all the respect in the world because I wouldn't be doing this without him. And I know he could definitely say the same back. So it's a collaborative effort. We appreciate each other a lot. And it's finally a full circle moment for the both of us to meet each other face to face. Okay, there he is, there he is. I see him, he's got that Northern Snow hoodie on though. He ain't expecting this, he ain't expecting this. There he is, the boy! Mazi! Yeah, I got it. Get in here, get in here. With the Northern Snow hoodie on.
My God, dude.
What's Holy. Up? What's up? I guess it's a bigger deal for us than the people watching, but. Dude. Good morning.
How are we doing today?
Good, good. How are you?
Oh, not too bad. What are we looking for?
Okay, I'm gonna get three grande. Appreciate it.
Oh, look at that. Boom. There you guys have it. We got cold brews for the entire team. But yeah, hate to admit it, I definitely come here basically every day, spend a little bit too much money. However, there's nothing that hits better than a Starbucks in the morning. And if there's anybody who disagrees, you guys are crazy. But it just doesn't end there for me. I like to be pretty much stimulated all day off caffeine. Hate to admit that as well, but that's just the truth. I have an addiction, I'm not gonna lie. If it's a gym day, I'll also maybe pound back an energy drink before hitting the gym. I definitely got to taper back a little bit. It's been something I've been meaning to get a little bit better at for my health, but I just love being caffeinated all day. I think it's more of like a placebo effect in your head. You know, getting up really early around like 4 or 5 a.m. By the time I go to the gym at like 4 p.m. at night and I've had a bunch of caffeine throughout the day, I don't think a little energy drink even does anything to me. I just think it's more of a mental thing, you know what I mean? That's all I got though. Besides that, you see me, I keep her dialed in. You guys have been skipping a lot of weeklies because there's been no growth, eh?
Yeah.
Well, it's not a bad thing. Speeds things up, I guess. Makes the week shorter.
And let the grass rejuvenate a little bit.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Well, okay, you boys have a good day. We're gonna come see you guys a little bit later on, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, be safe. Fully loaded too.
Yeah, that's all their times right there. Like how much they worked last week, how many hours. Kind of nice. Like I really, really like this because it shows accountability for each employee here so that they could see how many hours they work. Yeah, that basically shows all the hours for the employees to see if they worked up to their 40 hour base salary wage that they make every Friday. Cause it's a flat payment. Every Friday they get paid the same amount of money. And we try to get them to that 40 hours per week, but sometimes they only work 32 hours. Like this week, they might only work like 30, 32, because the grass hasn't been growing much. They've been skipping a lot of our weekly customers because they haven't been able to mow because there's been no growth. So we might have a shorter week, but that still means all the routes got done. So regardless, to us as a company, we get to see our fixed expenses by paying these employees a flat rate every single Friday. So whether they get the job done in 30 hours or 35 or 38, it is what it is. You know, they're just more efficient on the field. If there's some less growth, customers are still paying the same. We try to still go by their property, provide some value where we can, you know, trim a little bit here, pick up a little bit of debris over there, etc. But for the most part, that's just the way it goes. We like running it like this. It just makes sense. You know what I mean? It's more efficient for us. We get to know all of our fixed expenses right in front of us. We could plan a lot better. We know our profit margins a lot better and we're not playing around with per hour, you know, and the employees, which is the biggest part. Okay, not just about us as a company, does it make it more simple, but the employees, they love it. They love a guaranteed pay every Friday that they know they're gonna get if they just show up and get the routes done, whether it takes them 30 hours or 40, you know, it's a win-win. And they work harder to get it done. I explained this before, like they work their ass off to be like, yo, let's make it a shorter week. If we get everything done in 35, 32 hours, then we save ourselves, you know, an extra 5 to 7 or 8 hours of work. Why not work a little bit harder? But if they make mistakes, just to clear this up with everyone who commented on my last video, if you are making mistakes out in the field, these guys are liable to go back and fix them at no additional pay. So even if it takes them a whole day to fix an entire route, if they screwed it up, that has never ever happened, let alone even one property per route. But if they had to go and fix an entire route because they made a bunch of mistakes, and they clocked in at 50 hours of the week, they're still getting paid that base 40. They don't get paid additionally. So I had to clear that up. When they come in every single morning, the crew will go through the list together. It's like a morning checklist and then they have an evening checklist. So I'll dive into the morning one here. Morning checklist. Ensure all mowing equipment, trucks, and jerry cans are fueled before leaving. Start all mowing equipment to ensure everything is ready for the day. Perform a circle check of the truck and mowers. Load all mowing equipment into truck in designated spots. Check stock of consumables, water, trimmer line, flags. Ensure the tablet is working correctly in charge. Set alarm and lock shop just before leaving. If they didn't go over this checklist, how much time they would waste if they ran into a problem where, you know, maybe a machine didn't start or they get all the way to their first house and they have no trimmer line. Like these are why the checklists are important, because if we aren't doing our due diligence of checking over our lists to make sure that we have everything and we're prepared for the day, okay? The most important thing that I always emphasize is being prepared. You save a ton of time, you're ready to go, ready to go and tackle your day. Preparation's huge around here. Organization and preparation's big, because like when we get to where we need to be, we just wanna execute. We don't wanna waste any time, you know? This is the boys. I'm sorry, getting you guys on film, top of the morning. Yo, you already know what we're doing. We're prioritizing the pump. So we're gonna hit 20 minutes here at 6 miles per hour on the treadmill just to get nice and warmed up, get the heart going, get a little bit of a sweat on, and then we're gonna run into an intense upper body day here. So we'll take you guys along for the ride. 6.0 here, 20 minutes, burns about 300, 350 calories. I think it's about 4 kilometers. This is my regular routine though, 4 days a week, and this is how I start every workout. I just want to show you guys a picture of me back in the day, 7-8 years ago. Used to weigh close to 270 pounds. I think it was about like 263, 265. Came a long way. Right now weighing in at a solid 163 pounds. It's been a long progress in the weight loss journey, but feel good. Feel really good, feel healthy, feel light. Got lots of endurance, but I'm still not done yet. I'm on a big mission to get a six pack because I've never had one in my life. We're just getting started here. It's been quite the process the last 12 weeks working with Chris Clark on trying to lose some weight. I'm down about 8 pounds since I've been on his program, following a very strict nutrition diet and workout plan, but I'm honestly feeling the best I've ever felt in my entire life. So shout out Chris Clark. Thank you so much, man. I can't wait to get to the end of this program and
keep crushing some results for you and for me both. Six pack on the way. Just gotta stop eating that Dairy Queen after hours, I guess. Hey, Eric. That's it. Full workout done. I'm ready for lunch. We're going to Qdoba. Stay tuned. Okay, guys, you already know what time it is. After the nice Chris Clarkey, that's what I like to call it, the Chris Clarkey pump, we're gonna stop at the gain station here. Qdoba Mexican restaurant. I don't know if I consider it a restaurant, it's kind of fast food, but the healthiest fast food you'd get in Sault Ste. Marie, Ontario. So if I don't have any meal prep ready, because today's Sunday, which means my mom's currently cooking all my meals. They're gonna be ready for me tomorrow. I just come by here, Qdoba, get a quick little meal in and keep the calories in check. It's all clean, protein, freshly made. Can't complain, you know? I'm starving too. I'm starving. Ooh-wee! Second meal of the day for me. I usually like to keep it around 500-600 calories. We're gonna do a build your own bowl. That's what I usually get here. The chicken, brisket, looks great. Hey, how are you? I'm gonna do a build your own bowl, please. Beans, chicken, and vegetables. That's it. Keeping her dialed in. Yeah, that's perfect.
We got two scoops of rice, scoop of black beans, two scoops of spicy chicken, two scoops of pico, a little bit of mozzarella, and two scoops of guac, because I'm on the bulk, trying to put some
He's trying to put some weight on it. That's gotta be like 1,000 to 1,200 calories. No, 1,200 for sure. We're gonna dive in, we're gonna enjoy this after a beautiful workout, and yeah, we're at the gain station here, getting it in. Put it all yourself?
Yeah.
Look at this, man.
That's awesome.
That's a true man.
We got enough wood for the sauna for pretty much all winter long.